Hi everyone, my name is Sydney McGee and I'm the Dance Event Coordinator for Festival South. This year, due to COVID-19, we've had to postpone our 2020 events, but we are so excited to see you in 2021. The Hattiesburg dance community has put together a spectacular program for Festival South this year. We will be showcasing works from the Hub Dance Collective. We have a series of dance classes called Movement Mondays to keep you motivated and active during the summer. And we also have some Motown-inspired dance events for kids. We are so sad that we can't enjoy these events together, but we hope these videos and tutorials will inspire you to join us in 2021. Thank you so much for your continued support of Festival South, and we hope to see you soon. Hi everyone, my name is Sydney McGee. I'm a professional dancer and choreographer. We're going to be doing a dance today to Meghan Trainor's Better When I'm Dancing. This was going to be one of our Movement Monday classes, the Feeling Myself Heels class following our Kinky Boots premiere. You don't need heels for this, it's totally optional. This dance was designed for everyone, moms, dads, aunts, uncles, brothers, sisters, whoever wants to come dance with us, I hope you guys will join us. Like I said, heels are totally optional. You can wear bare feet or tennis shoes, whatever you feel comfortable in. Put on some comfy clothes that you can dance in, something that makes you feel confident and ready to move. And yeah, let's get started. So I'm mirroring you completely so you can watch me and follow along exactly. So when I move this way, you're gonna move to your right. When I move this way, you're gonna move to your left, okay? So at the beginning, you have a little bit of freestyle. It's kind of dance it out, you're having your little dance party. So you're gonna dance it out, and then we have 5, 6, 7, 8. You're gonna step out on your right foot. 1, hit your hip. 2, 3, hit your hip. 4, and then you're gonna rock it out, whatever style you're feeling. If you're feeling girly or you wanna be a little more swaggy, take your pick, whatever you wanna do, but you're gonna rock it out on 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? Then you're gonna step and put your hand on your head. You're gonna go 1, 2, tap to the other side. 3, 4, same thing, rock it out 4 times, whatever style you're feeling, going 5, 6, 7, 8, awesome. From there, you have another little dance party. You're gonna step and tap your feet together. Your hands have freedom to do whatever they want. So you're gonna go step and tap, step and tap, step and tap, step and tap. Again, you can do whatever you want with your hands, whatever you're feeling. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, hit 2, 3, hit 4, rock it out. 6, 7, 8. 1, head 2, 3, head 4, and 5, 6, 7, step, tap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, you're gonna step it out. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you're feeling it, you can kind of do a little head nod on 3, 4. We walk around ourselves in a circle, going 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? From there, we're almost there. We're gonna do a grapevine. If you don't know what a grapevine is, it's an old school step. You start with a step out, so you go out, then you step behind. Then you step out again, and then you jump and clap together. And then you go the other way. So you go step, behind, step, clap together. It is a little bit faster than that, so let's do that one more time. So you just did 1, 2, 3, 4, walking 5, 6, 7, grapevine. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, the last little step, you're gonna cha-cha roll to your right. You're gonna go up and up, and down, and down, and this is the fun part. At the very end, you're gonna hit a pose. You can hit whatever pose you want. So you can go up, you can maybe go like this, you can go down, whatever kind of pose you're feeling, you're just gonna hit your pose. And then you can freestyle the rest of the song, or if you wanna freestyle and then repeat this dance at the chorus, you totally can, it's up to you. And that's it, everybody, that's all we got. So we're gonna do it one more time, and then we're gonna do it with music, okay? Here we go, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, hit 2, 3, hit 4, going 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, head 2, 3, 4, rock it out. 6, 7, 8, and step, tap, step, tap, and 5, 6, point to the front. 1, 2, walk in a circle. 5, 6, to the grapevine goes. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, cha-cha, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I don't know about you, but I feel better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. I'm better when I'm dancing. Yeah, yeah. And we can do this together. I bet you feel better when you're dancing. Yeah, yeah. Bye bye, bye bye.
I'm Kelsey Wishick. I'm a Mississippi native from the Gulf Coast.
Well, I was excited to be asked to participate in Festival South. And of course, the first thing that I was thinking about with how to connect with the concept was my experience with Hattiesburg. I've spent a lot of time on the Leaf River in the woods playing music myself. And I always kind of have this like myth that I tell myself about this man in the river who's perpetually playing music for all of time. And I've done several paintings and drawings of this river myth man, and kind of showed up again in this work. I thought it would be interesting to give him a kind of unique instrument. So he's playing the banjo-lele, a little small banjo-ukulele mix. And I kind of worked with the idea of the appearance of kinky boots in the festival to just give him these vibrant boots to ground him into the river. So he's very much a part of nature and participating in the landscape. And that's kind of how I spent my time here in Hattiesburg, always outside, enjoying the beauty that is offered here. So the color in this painting, it actually came in response to an actual sunrise that I experienced as I was starting to conceive this idea. I was really struck by this kind of lemon yellow that happened one morning. I don't think I've ever seen that color before in real life until that day. And it became this kind of surreal experience that I was having and that I wanted maybe the viewer to be able to touch into. So it's just this really vibrant springtime, early springtime colors, and kind of just pushing that surreal moment of being integrated with everything. So like there's this swooping, like he's kind of swooping into the trees. The trees are becoming into the atmosphere. So everything is connected in a way. And I wanted to play with that, with the colors too. So even his jeans, his shirt, it becomes kind of atmospheric or like the river, like the landscape. So trying to push that connection. I'm always thinking about the nature of water and the fluidity of water and the contrasting nature of the different elements. But I feel always quite drawn to water and that kind of ability for it to reflect our stories and our moments. And I always think of water when I'm in Hattiesburg for some reason because of the rivers. When I think of creativity in relationship to the pandemic, my experience has been to, you know, take an initial pause and assess what is most important to me as a creator, not to just create compulsively. So it's been actually a really beautiful time to step back and reintegrate into the vision process of creativity. So obviously sometimes it just comes and it flows, and other times it really starts with how I feel like creativity starts with how we see life and how an artist sees life. So I've been really cultivating that direct contact with the places that I'm in, the kind of empathy that I feel for the situation, and allowing it to slow down a little bit. Yeah, I always think of creativity as a kind of technology of what we can create with what we have. So in that way, I also think this time has really brought us back to what is essential. It's not always about maybe the product or the object or the show, but also that kind of fulfillment and relationship with the medium directly. We're kind of coming from this time. The past few years have been really hard with all the challenges we're facing with minorities, Me Too movement, just everything's kind of come up in the past few years. And I feel like it's been a kind of time of lamenting. And I hope that on the other side of this, that we can come to really celebrate the sacredness of diversity in life and spread more color and light through our art.
And people stayed home and read books and listened and they rested and did exercises and made art and played and learned new ways of being and stopped and listened more deeply. Someone meditated, someone prayed, someone met their shadow, and people began to think differently, and people healed. And in the absence of people who lived in ignorant ways, dangerous, meaningless, and heartless, the earth also began to heal. And when the danger ended and people found themselves, they grieved for the dead and made new choices and dreamed of new visions and created new ways of living and completely healed the earth, just as they were healed.